Historical Commission, Dorothy Leopanitis, Dorothy McKinnon, Jean Rowe, Jean Ryle, Frank West, and Ann Berghaus, I wish to welcome you to the induction ceremony of the West Schoolhouse into the National Register of Historic Places. We are obviously very excited that this one-room schoolhouse has been voted worthy of national historic recognition. The goal of the Wilmington Historic Commission is the recognition and the preservation of our historic buildings throughout town. In a sense, we are conservationists seeking to protect our historic resources for future generations. The West Schoolhouse is our second town-owned building to be placed on the National Register of Historic Places. Of course, the Middlesex Canal is nationally recognized. Our first building, town-owned building, to be placed on the National Register was the Haddon Tavern, which was placed in 1976. The tavern is open to the public the first Sunday of each month, and the Friends of the Haddon Tavern do a wonderful job supporting the tavern and working, sponsoring many activities, a harvest festival, Christmas social, strawberry festival, in support of their many programs. We encourage you all to come over and visit the Haddon Tavern. In addition to the tavern, through private efforts, a residence known as the Buck House was added to the National Register of Historic Places this year. But we are here today to honor the West School. It's certainly fitting, as children are returning to classrooms to start a new school year, that we have this dedication for our one-room schoolhouse. Many here perhaps have memories of your days at the West School. School is something that we all somehow like to reminisce about. We all have school in common. We like to talk about our teachers, funny incidences. Particularly, we like to talk about our friends. And we make those friends and we share a common bond with them, and that common bond becomes a community. So in that respect, it's very fitting that we are here today to recognize the school as symbolic of the community of Wilmington. At this time, we would like to introduce the first several guest speakers we are very privileged to have with us. Representative James Maselli.
Thank you, Carolyn. Thank you for inviting me to participate in today's ceremonies. The addition of Wilmington's West Schoolhouse to the National Register of Historic Places. I know how hard so many people have worked on this project, and congratulations are most appropriate for Carolyn Harris and the members of the Wilmington Historical Commission, the town officials, and state officials who are all working together with folks from the National Register. May this day a reality. Others here can testify to the architectural merits of this structure, and others still will be able to plot the exact history of this structure. For my part, I'd simply like to take note of the fact that this building, this schoolhouse, seems a most appropriate monument to our town's development over the years, because Wilmington's past, and indeed her future, revolve around the concept of education. Our once rural and agricultural community has evolved in a community of complex industries and businesses demanding complex skills. We've grown and we've flourished because, as symbolized by the West Schoolhouse, education has always been a central piece of the Wilmington community. Looking at the West Schoolhouse, one must think of our ancestors of many, many generations ago who invested their land and their lumber, their time and their trades into building this and other early schools. And in the same way, we must remember the children, the many generations of children, and the many generations of devoted teachers who made the school alive with learning. I recently came across a quote by Winston Churchill, which seems especially appropriate today. "We shape our buildings," Churchill said, "thereafter they shape us." The West Schoolhouse has shaped us in so many fine and wonderful ways, and as I said, it's a pleasure to be here participating in the ceremony this afternoon. And I'd like to read a letter and make a presentation, and it's to dear Chairwoman Harris. The United States flag that has been presented to you was flown at the Massachusetts State House on August 17, 1990, by Gregory Arnold, Superintendent of State Buildings, in honor of the West School dedication per my request. I wish to extend my sincerest appreciation to the Wilmington Historical Commission for their efforts in making this dedication possible. And it's signed James Masali, State Representative, and I'd like to make that presentation at this time.
At this time, I would like to present Representative Augie Grace.
Thank you. I can tell we're all going to have fun passing this microphone back and forth to each other. But it's a pleasure for me to be here this afternoon for this dedication ceremony on such a beautiful day. The West School is part of a proud heritage the town of Wilmington possesses, and it is fitting that a schoolhouse here in Massachusetts, the birthplace of public school systems, be placed on the National Register of Historical Places. It is vitally important that structures which are part of a town's heritage be preserved for what they represent and for what they teach us. The West School is a monument to the town of Wilmington's commitment to public education, a commitment that has been steadfastly held and steadfastly kept since Wilmington's earliest days. That such schoolhouses were built and maintained demonstrates what a priority our forebears placed on providing access to all of us and access to free, quality education. I hope that today we continue to realize what a cherished thing our public education system truly is. The townspeople who voted over a century ago to construct this schoolhouse recognize, as we should, how important public schools are, and how important they are to the individual, to make them both better as individuals themselves and to give them the opportunity to further themselves in our society. They recognize, as we should, that if our institutions of free government are to survive, all citizens must have access to an education. We must not forget, as they have not, that education is the strongest tool we have in confronting the problems of our community, our state, and our country. Let us preserve the schoolhouses and let them serve to remind us of the values our forebears placed on public education, a value which is as constant today as it was a century ago. And let us use today's ceremony to renew Wilmington's historic commitment to its public schools, that they may remain our most valued assets. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative Grace. At this time, I would like to read several good wishes that have been sent to the Historical Commission to the West School. The first, Town of Wilmington Historical Commission. Dear friends, I would like to extend my most sincere congratulations to the people of Wilmington on the occasion of the West Schoolhouse listing in the National Historic Register. It is an honor for the Commonwealth to have one of Wilmington's earliest surviving schoolhouses listed in the National Register and therefore given the protection and recognition it deserves. With best wishes, sincerely, Edward M. Kennedy. Town of Wilmington, dear friends, to the citizens of Wilmington, I send my warmest congratulations on the attainment of special historic recognition for the West Schoolhouse. Being enrolled in the National Register of Historic Places is a wonderful honor, and it serves as a constant reminder of the rich New England heritage which exists in our everyday lives. I have long been an advocate for the establishment and preservation of precious historic and natural resources. Such designations are an excellent method for passing on our culture's traditions and values as learning tools for future generations. Once again, I am most pleased that the town of Wilmington has received this well-deserved recognition, and I am honored, as always, to serve as its representative on behalf of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Sincerely, John F. Kerry, United States Senate. The third letter that we have received, Wilmington Historic Commission, Thank you for your kind invitation and that of the Wilmington Historic Commission to join with you at the dedication ceremony at the Old West Schoolhouse on Saturday, September 8, 1990. Unfortunately, my calendar will not permit me to attend as I have previous commitment at that time. As you know, I do have fond memories of having lived in Wilmington as a small child back in 1922. My family rented Pop Nielsen's son's home while my brother Bill was recovering from pneumonia. The neighbors were just beautiful and so warm and friendly. I regret that I shall be unable to be with you, but please convey my best wishes to all. Thank you again for thinking of me with every good wish. Sincerely, Thomas P. O'Neill. In addition to those letters we received from United States Representative Edward Markey's office, a flag that flew over the Capitol building for the West Schoolhouse. Representative Jeff Beckwith will not be with us today. He sends his regrets and best wishes to us all in this dedication ceremony. At this time, I would like to introduce to you Elsa Fitzgerald, who is the Acting Executive Director of the Massachusetts Historical Commission, who will present the Certificate of Registration in the National Register of Historic Places to Mark T. Haldane from the Wilmington Board of Selectmen. Thank you, Carolyn. I think one of the outstanding things that I'm very happy to be here and to observe today is that preservation is really people. And somehow the Old West Schoolhouse is a real tangible element of the heritage of the town of Wilmington. And I think that's one of the outstanding things that I am here to do today is to congratulate Carolyn Harris and all the hard work of the Wilmington Historical Commission, but also all the people of the town of Wilmington, because you've taken this step to preserve community character. And preservation of community character, as we know, is one of the one tangible things that we have to pass on to our young people and generations to come. So I congratulate you on today's nomination to the National Register of Historic Places, as well as to the renewed interest in historic preservation that is so apparent in the town of Wilmington historic places. The National Register is the nation's official listing of buildings, districts, sites, structures, and objects which retain their historical character and are important to our local, state, or national history. The National Register was established under the National Historic Preservation Act of 1966 and is administered in the Commonwealth by the Massachusetts Historical Commission. And signed by Michael Joseph Conley, Secretary of State and Chairman of the Mass Historic Commission.
Thank you, Mrs. Fitzgerald, Mrs. Harris, members of the great general court, distinguished guests and ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed my pleasure to be here today on behalf of Chairman Doucette and the members of the Wilmington Board of Selectmen to participate in this dedication. Events such as this are more than a mere acknowledgement that this building has survived various storms and weathered the development of the area over time. Progress demands that we replace much of what is old, but progress also demands that we determine who we are to become by maintaining a connection with who we were. The preservation and protection of the West Schoolhouse contributes to the progress of Wilmington. The West Schoolhouse is a part of the town historically and culturally. Indeed, it helped shape the town's history. That history is not recoverable simply by asserting its experience. Its value lies where the present intersects with the historical experience, that is tradition, that part of the past that lives in the present. The failure to understand tradition exposes the people of Wilmington to historical amnesia to becoming psychological gypsies or a cut flower society. The West Schoolhouse was erected in the midst of the American Industrial Revolution. Ulysses S. Grant was the President of the United States. The year that the West Schoolhouse was constructed, Vice President Henry Wilson died. We've adopted 11 amendments to the United States Constitution since then, and 87 amendments to the Massachusetts Constitution. Eli Whitney had not dreamed of the cotton gin, and in fact, the Sioux had not dreamed of George Armstrong Custer. The 37 states of the Union were preparing for the nation's centennial celebration. Since this building was constructed, the country has seen Indian Wars, the Spanish-American War, two world wars, a depression that many think was as much hell as war, Korea, Vietnam, and many other armed struggles that have traumatized us as a people. We're anxious for something a bit steadier, something that has continuity in it. We look to our tradition and we look to work to confirm in the present what the people of Wilmington once found to be glorious and wonderful and inspirational. The West Schoolhouse is just such a place. For many people, the architecture of this building justifies saving it. For others, the fact that it is one of the oldest structures in town is the key motivation for saving it. But to me, it's not just the building, but what the building represents. Just as our churches and synagogues are more than just buildings, but are the people who breathe life into those organizations, the West Schoolhouse is the teachers who taught several grades here, the students who were educated, and the ways in which this place has influenced those teachers and those students, and how they have influenced others. The West Schoolhouse reminds us of Wilmington's agricultural past. For some, it reminds us of friends who attended this school and of the days gone by. It may remind us that once upon a time you could buy a quarter of an acre of land for $25 or construct a school for less than $1,500. We can learn from the arguments for and against district schools as opposed to a centralized school system. This old district school reminds us that those old arguments can be and are relived in a different context today. Centralization versus decentralization remains a hot political and philosophical issue. Today, let us take time to thank the Wilmington Historical Commission for their work to preserve the continuity between our past and our present. Thanks also to the National Register of Historic Places for understanding the importance of preserving our history and offering tax incentives and other resources to allow preservation to continue. Thank the town historian, Captain Lars Nielsen, whose newspaper serves as a living history for our town. We should also remember those who have gone before us, people such as Foster Balzer and many others who devoted so much of themselves to the preservation of Wilmington's history. Through the dedication of places such as the West Schoolhouse, we'll remember how Wilmington arrived at this point in history, and we'll be in a better position to create its future. Let each of us go forward from here today with a little better understanding of where we have been, determined to do our part to change what is failing and preserve that which is important and worthy to us as a people. Thank you for allowing me to participate today, and thank you for coming out on such a beautiful fall afternoon.
Gentlemen, I can assure you that the informality of my attire is going to be synonymous with the informality of my remarks. I'm going to be very brief. First of all, somebody should acknowledge whoever it is that is responsible for such beautiful weather. I don't know if we should give Carolyn Harris credit for that or not. Captain Nielsen told me it was he who had the direct pipeline and made that request. I just want to offer my congratulations, as well as all of you have offered your congratulations, to the Wilmington Historical Commission I think it's so important that we not miss one concept here. We're talking about history and how important it is to recognize the historical activities that have gone on in our community and really throughout the state and the country. It's also important to recognize what brings us here today, and that is the spirit of volunteerism. And I think that it is the movement and the efforts of volunteers like Ann Berghaus, who did so much work here today and who's been around here with her entire family, and Carolyn Harris, and all of the members of the Wilmington historical community that brings us here. And it's very important that we recognize that. And I'm pleased that Selectman Haldane mentioned Foster Balser, because all of you have that program before you. And he, too, was the ultimate volunteer for the town of Wilmington and deserves so much credit for the Wilmington community being conscious of their commitment to preserving history and to making its everlasting promotion. So I'm very, very thankful to be a part of this program. I would like to call your attention and congratulate the many different town departments, such as public buildings and the highway department, and these gentlemen from the police department, all of whom have participated in bringing us to this point. And congratulate also the Wilmington Minuteman Company for the work that they're doing. And I also want to acknowledge the assistant town manager, Jeff Hull, who worked very, very hard with Carolyn in planning for today's beautiful day. So congratulations to you all, and enjoy the rest of the day. I know I'm going to leave the real comments to Captain Nielsen, who's going to fill us in, I think, on some of the anecdotes of the past and those that are associated with this wonderful school. Thank you.
Thank you, Carol. I would like to introduce to you Dr. Shirley Cowan, chairperson of the Wilmington School Committee.
Thank you for inviting me here today to what is obviously a very special event for me and for all of us. You know, this morning as I began to think about what I could say that would be meaningful, I found myself lost in thinking about the school itself, about what was contained within these walls, the lives of children and the stories, the children's hopes and the children's dreams in the past, and how much meaning they still have today. And it seemed to me that really defines the criteria for placement on the National Register of Historic Places. Events and people that have significance to our past. And what could have more significance to our past and to our future than a schoolhouse like this, and education and our children? And then I began to think about education, and I could talk all day about that. However, I think education is probably loosely defined as an understanding gained through experience and through study. It builds knowledge, it builds skill, it builds mind, and it builds character. But you know, I'd like to add my own definition to that. There's some words of Mark Twain's, but I think they fit here. I think education really is a light to our feet, a guide to our feet, and a light to our understanding. Thank you so much for inviting me. Wilmington Superintendent of Schools.
I think we all have our reasons for being here today, and I'll get the professional ones out of the way. I bring the greetings of the Wilmington Public Schools, which obviously for many, many years had an interest in this building. But my real pleasure, if you will, in being here today, being pleased to be invited, is really more personal. I myself am a product of the Wilmington Public Schools. I grew up on Brand Avenue, which is just a short walk across the canal, across the railroad tracks. When I was a boy growing up here, it's a mystery to me why I didn't attend this school. I went to the Mildred Rogers, which is actually a little further away down the lake, and I still can't understand why I didn't come here, but I'm sure there was a good reason. But my memories go back to everything from including the days when the Coombs family lived in this White House right across the street, and the opposite corner was an open field, and the, if you'll pardon the reminiscing, the Brand Avenue Bombers, as we were known, used to come over here and play the Shawsheen Avenue group counterparts. And we used to bounce a few baseballs off of this building, and I don't think Mrs. Eames was very pleased about all of that. I also remember Mrs. Eames well. Behind you up on the hill before all of these houses were here, the original farm building, the farmhouse that the Eames family lived in, and all of this area behind you was all, among other things, some of the finest strawberry fields as you've ever seen. I can remember getting the princely sum of 14 cents a box when I was about 12 years old to pick those strawberries. So there's a lot of things that rush to mind. I can even remember the night looking out my bedroom window over on Grand Avenue when the original farmhouse burned to the ground one night. I'm sure there are many of you out there in the audience that remember that. So there's a lot of mixed feelings and emotions to be here, but on top of all of those things I've told you, I'm also a trained history teacher, so you can see my affinity for anything that's old and anything that's going to be preserved. And I think that if you grew up in Wilmington and you remember Wilmington back in the 30s and 40s and 50s, as many of you do, when the time, I remember Wilmington in 1950, when you could go up to Wilmington Center and you knew every single person you saw. Those days are certainly gone, and a lot of the things that those of us as children in Wilmington remember are gone. But fortunately, there's a lot of things that are still left, and this is one of them, and the Middlesex Canal and Silver Lake, there are some things that you just can't do away with. So, speaking personally, I am privileged to be here today. And as a closing note, I want to thank the representatives for their strong philosophical support for education that they gave us, because I'm sure that that will translate out into fiscal support in the upcoming years, because I would hate to think that at some given point in time I'd have to go back to the Historical Society and say, excuse me, do you mind if we use this as a school again? So thank you very much for having me. It's a privilege, and on with the program.
One of the reasons that the Historical Commission pursued the registration of the West Schoolhouse was the support that was given to us by Buzz Strapchinski, our former town manager. And we're delighted that he is with us today. Buzz?
It is gratifying to be here. The odyssey that started today's event began probably 8 to 9 years ago when I was first appointed town manager. Foster Balzer would come in and visit with me and told me about the West School and said, we've got to do something to that building before it falls apart or before it gets torn down or before the weather takes it away. Told me that he had an idea, he had a dream, and his dream was to make this a museum. He had contacted somebody at Boston and Maine. He had found a old wood-burning stove, maybe it was a coal-burning stove, that was used in a school someplace that the Boston and Maine had acquired and put aside. That was the beginning of the artifacts that he was acquiring for this building. So someone said that preservation really is people. And as I reflect on this building and today, I have to think of the people who have been involved. Dorothy Lafinatis, Carolyn, of course. When Carolyn first became the chairman of the Wilmington Historical Commission, she came in, we had a little visit, and she indicated that she really wanted to open up the commission and get into some other areas. Before, they were quite focused on the Wilmington's Harnden Tavern. She wanted to open it up and look at other things. They had been doing the plaque program. I think some of you recognize those plaques on historic buildings around town. But she said there are other things that we ought to be doing in the preservation area, and that the West School certainly lent itself to an application for registration on the National Register. I said, fine, let's get to work on that. And I think about that time, Jeff Hull started as assistant town manager. So I threw the file and the paperwork to Jeff. He worked with Carolyn and put together the necessary documentation about 2 years ago. And it took that length of time for us to be registered. In between times, there was a site visit here, and we had to go into Boston to the JFK Library for a meeting of the Massachusetts Historical Commission when they actually voted on this. They had a very nice slideshow. Someone came out, took slides, and a staff person reviewed the application and made a presentation on our behalf. And that was in December of 89. So, as I said, there are a number of people involved. Mike Kyer in his comments talked about volunteerism, and I'd just like to go through the list of the Historical Commission commissioners who I have had the pleasure of working with. Herb Fielding, Evelyn Kaminsky, Ruth Harding, Frank Curley, here today, Leo Gitzis, who's here, Foster Balzer, who unfortunately passed away this past year, Barney McMahon, who I believe is here, and Bob Wright. Bob Wright was a chairman. I'm not sure if Bob is here. And then the roster of current members, Gene Rowe, Frank West, Mike Bridges, a former member, Gene Ryle, and as I said, Dorothy Lafinatis and Dorothy McKinnon. So it's these people who really made my job as town manager fun. I've made that comment, I think perhaps at my going away party, and people laughed that the job of town manager is fun, and the Historical Commission made it that way because I think as many of you know, my job, or in this case now, Mike's job is filled with budgets and personnel and finding ways to cut and save money and carry on with the mission of the town. And so much of it is high stress and it can be a bit of a challenge. But when either Dorothy came in as chairman or Bob Wright or Carolyn now, it was always joyous to talk to them because we were talking about history, something as a history buff. It was quite pleasant and really brought my mind away from the day-to-day cares that can sometimes invade the office. So with that, I'll just say that the commission has really been loyal to its three charges, that of protection, that of preservation, and that of education. And I commend you for that effort. Keep up the good work, and I hope in a short period of time to be in the audience when the Center District Historical District is presented with an award. Thank you.
This afternoon, Foster Balzer's name has come up again and again. He's indeed a remarkable man whose real goal in life was to preserve this building. With this in mind, I'd like to introduce to you fellow Commissioner Dorothy Lafinatis.
Members of the Historical Commission are volunteers, as you probably know, and we sure work like the dickens. But at the same time, none could have been more dedicated than Foster Balzer. Inside the building, you will find letters and other material that he put together and put into an envelope and handed to me a number of years ago. You will find that some of the letters date back to 1980, but the one that is almost like what is on the back of your program is also up on the bulletin board for you to see. You see, I'm a teacher, used to be a teacher, and I can't help but say bulletin boards, even though someone else might call them some other names. One of the things that Foster Balzer, as you've already heard, was interested in, besides the school, was being sure that we had a potbelly stove. So my request goes out to you. Look far and wide, and please, let's find a potbelly stove to have in commemoration of Foster Balzer. The other thing, too, I'd like to tell you, is that they thought that it might be nice for you to dress up a little bit differently today, and someone said you should carry a ruler. And I talked to some other people, and they said, In no way would Mrs. Eames use a ruler. However, I did find out from Mrs. Crispo that when Ernie Crispo was a member of the school committee, he came to the school with a visitor one day. And I think even before the visitor was introduced to Mrs. Eames, she ended up in going to the closet and said to a little one, "You may come out now." And I found out from others that that's the sort of thing that she used to like to do. But for those of you who might not be able to find a potbelly stove, if it's possible for you to find an old school bell that we can be sure to be engraved with Foster Ball's name, that too would be very, very welcome.
Thank you, Dr. Any historic event in Wilmington would be remiss without our next guest speaker, Captain Lars Nielsen. Captain Nielsen, we all enjoy almost weekly your historical articles in the Town Crier. We're looking forward to hearing many of your comments about the West Schoolhouse. Captain Nielsen?
I've read the obituary of him, the person who wrote it didn't understand quite what it was, but it said he worked on longitude. Well, the school closed about 1894. That was a combination. Mr. Faye, do you know this book? Anyway, that was a combination high school and grammar school, and that gathered a lot of the pupils. Then they built another school, 1894, about a half a mile closer to the railroad station, and somehow the Walker family heard about that. And the Walker family, I don't know how much they contributed, but they must have made a contribution because the school was named the Walker School, and it stood there in its majesty for many years until we got a town manager, who I won't mention. The school stayed closed from about 1895 until the end of World War I. And by this time, some years before, the Walker family had left this house up in Commonwealth of Massachusetts, started, brought up the camp or something, state police. The state police were reactivated, and this school was taken over by the state police for 2 years. They had four policemen and four horses. I never saw any motorcycles. And I don't know where the horses lived. They must have been in the barn up at the next house. But when that was emptied, the place was a wreck. I don't know why cops wreck things, but they do occasionally. Are they there? And it was empty. It was a Boy Scout troop. Town, Troop 1, Wilmington. Hubert E. Cann was a scoutmaster. And I was one of the valiant Boy Scouts, and there were others. We met in the Methodist Church. We met in the Congregational Church. Things weren't quite satisfactory. Cann looked at this building. And he asked me, "Can your father get this building for us?" My father's on the school committee. And my father made arrangements, and they really fixed it up. The wiring had all been ripped out. The windows had been ripped out. I don't think it cost the town of Wilmington anything. The fathers of the Boy Scout troop that rebuilt the school. Everybody can put in the wiring. He happened to be a Canadian rare that woman. When he went to the parade for Memorial Day with the Boy Scouts, he wore his old Canadian uniform. I didn't notice it, but he always said, did you notice him scowling at me? I was a Boy Scout troop for 2 years. And after that, I can't tell you, I wasn't here. But it did become a school again, and Lee Shaw Eames was the teacher. And I do recall seeing her here occasionally. She was a very gracious lady. And by 1940, the end of World War II, I was over in Iraq at that time. But in 1940, the school was really opened up. Lena Eames was down here, and things were getting pretty crowded, I guess, in Wilmington, because I've been told by one lady that the school bus stopped here three times every morning and three times every afternoon, going one way to another, and sometimes they'd have to get off and wait and come on again. So I would say that from 1940 to about 1955, it was a pretty populated school, and then again it closed up because the new high school had been built. Perhaps our friend Mr. McMahon can give a little more light on that point, and I think I finished my discussion.
Thank you, Captain Nelson. On behalf of the Wilmington Historical Commission, I'd like to conclude these proceedings with a few very special thanks. It takes a great deal of time and effort to put together a program of this nature. I would first like to thank our many distinguished speakers this afternoon for being willing to participate in this dedication. I'd like to thank Mr. Curley and the Wilmington Minuteman Company for being here with us today. I would like to extend a very special thanks to Jeff Hall, the Assistant Town Manager, for his hard work and his support. And for the many commissions in town that have been so cooperative in working with us, Roger Lassard and the Public Buildings Crew, and particularly Earl Lesperance, who was absolutely fantastic. Bob Palmer in the Public Works Department. Judy Johnson, the Wilmington Garden Club, for their hard work and effort to beautify this building. The Friends of the Harden Tavern. The Wilmington Council for the Arts. The 4th of July Committee. Everyone that we went to and asked for support were more than willing to help us. I would like to mention at this time the many town merchants who willingly donated to make our presentation, our reception possible. Rocco's Restaurant and Jamula's, Lucci's, DeCrosta Florist, Flowers by Dawn, The Flower Stop, Yen Tile, The Plate Escape, they all volunteer, and we're really appreciative of their effort. And so many private citizens stopped by and were willing to help us out. I particularly want to thank Adele Passmore, and when you go inside and take a look at her wonderful displays, you'll understand. She's put hours of work into this. We all appreciated it, though. In addition, I want to thank Steve Berghaus for his hard work, and Bonnie and Doug Smith, and a very special thanks to my husband, Greg Harris, for his support, too. Thank you all. It was wonderful to see so many people here helping us celebrate this special event, and would like to invite you all in to see our displays and enjoy some refreshments. Thank you. That's a great question. How many people are here today with us that attended this school?
Yeah.
Would you please stand up? That is absolutely fantastic. very much.